Ferrex, the AIM listed iron ore and manganese development company, has provided an update on the Nayega manganese project. I am joined by the company's chief executive, Dave Reeves. Dave, thanks for being with us today.
Charlotte, always a pleasure.
Now, Dave, can you talk us through what today's statement means for investors? It looks as though an open pit manganese operation is likely, isn't it?
We certainly believe it's a lot more than likely. We'd say a certainty. The environmental permit is due in October. That's based on a workshop that we've recently had. And the mining permit, we believe, will be issued quarter four after recent discussions with the Ministry of Mines. So all being equal with those permits in place, there's no reason for a manganese mine not to start production and development sometime next year.
And when can we expect to see the results of the DFS?
Results of the DFS, we are obviously dependent on the timing of the mining permit with its final fiscal regime. But post that, that will be within probably a month or so of receiving that mining permit, we should be able to complete the DFS. So let's say early quarter one 2015.
Dave, can you tell us what's different with the new ferromanganese strategy?
Yeah, the ferromanganese strategy we see is a second string to the bow and quite an exciting one. Originally, the concept when we first looked at Nayega and what the definitive feasibility study is based on is an open pit producing a saleable ore-grade concentrate that gets shipped off to China. The ferromanganese strategy sees downstream beneficiation of that manganese in Togo. And we move from being a shorter life, reasonable cash flow operation into a long life, very healthy cash flow operation with solid financials from both an NPV and IRR point of view. And we're very excited about that, in the fact that as soon as you get to be a lowest quartile producer in any mineral regime, you're in a very comfortable spot. You know you'll survive all the cycles that mining tends to throw at you, and will be profitable through all those cycles. So we see it as changing Nayega from a near-term cash flow that helps fund other projects into a very decent project in its own return, its own right, sorry, with decent returns in dividend flows over decades to come.
And Dave, going back to the environmental permit, you seem very confident you'll get it in the fourth quarter this year. So what's your relationship with the Togolese government like?
We've got a great working relationship with the Togolese government, in particular the Ministry of Mines. A case in point would be the recent workshop we held at Nayega, which they helped to host. We had representatives of many ministries and departments up there, from environment and power and water, many others. And, their support and guidance is invaluable in obviously securing a permit, but in navigating through to that point. And there certainly seems to be a very large push from the Togolese government to get these permits issued so we can commence development. Because certainly it's, benefit of not only ourselves, but the Togolese people as well, that we get the operation up and running as soon as we can.
Now, Anglo-American recently decided not to fund the Mebaga iron ore project in Gabon. Are you in talks with other partners?
Yeah, we certainly are. I mean, it's a very interesting time in regards to Mebaga and Gabon. We have had a lot of correspondence with a lot of different entities, from companies in the area through to mining companies, through to traders, through to funds. And I think we are seeing a depressed iron price at the moment. I think that has shaken up the area. And I think there will be actually quite a lot of good that comes out of this, where you start to see a lot more cooperation between people in that area. And it's only going to be to the benefit of those countries and those projects.
Is today's statement a signal that you are focusing more on Nayega than Mebaga?
No, we've always had, I'd say, equal focus between the two. We do certainly see Nayega as a nearer term cash flow and production opportunity. Obviously, you know, we've applied for a mining permit there, whereas we're in the early stages of exploration in Gabon. So I think it's fair to say we see Nayega as a short-term operation and Gabon as a longer-term blue sky operation. But we certainly have equal focus on both.
Dave, to wrap up, what's next for the company? What can investors look forward to?
Well, I think obviously we need to work hard to secure firstly the environmental permit, then the mining permit. We're working in tandem with that on funding for the manganese side of the business, which we're fairly advanced on. We need to find a replacement for Anglo in Gabon and how we're going to move forward there. So there's a lot happening in that regard. And obviously, as those various projects progress, there'll be news flow with them, be it exploration in Gabon through to the advancement of the DFS and the ferromanganese strategy in Togo.
Okay, Dave, thanks for the update.
Absolute pleasure.
Dave Reeves, CEO at Ferrex, the AIM-listed iron ore and manganese development company.